Morning, beautiful boys. Just thought I'd send this message just before I go and hop on the plane. I hope I catch some big fish and then I can show you all the pictures when I come home next week. What if I left any
day one, arrived at the infamous One Tree Beach. It is, words can't describe what this place is like. It is insane, it is so cool. I wish I could share it with all of you, so I'm gonna try and take as many videos and as many photos as possible so you can see. My bed, my window, and check out this review. You thought Warra was good. Just as good here. Very, very nice.
I don't care, go on and tear me apart. morning. Check this out. There's just little waterfalls everywhere. It's all fresh water just flowing in. There's little fish in here. There's all sorts. It's magnificent. Wish you were here.
We have had a massive few days up here. It has been insane. I'm exhausted, I'm knackered, my wrist is knackered, my armpits are bruised, my arms are bruised, my stomach is bruised, but we have had a ball. The fish tally has been insane, the types of fish have been insane, the sizes are huge. Yeah, awesome fun, awesome fun. All right, love and miss you lots. Bye.
On video, make it look good.
Hi boys, we had a fantastic day in the water today. Your mum outfished me, no worries at all. It started off when we both hit GTs at the same time. Mine lasted about 2 seconds and your mum got about a 40 pounder. It was unbelievable. Yeah, maybe I added an extra 10 pound, but it was a great fish. and then we did some excellent trolling. We got with some really big Spanish mackerel. Your mum got a huge Queenie, and I don't know whether she told you the other day, but she most probably got the best cod that the guide has ever seen, a golden spotted cod. It was huge. So we're having a pretty good time up here, boys. You'll have to save up your money and come up here one day. Love you lots. Bye.
Oh, and I got a GT. Now, this GT took me 20 minutes and dragged me 300 meters around the Osborne Islands to get into the boat. It was quite possibly the hardest fighting fish I've ever caught in my life. At one point I did not think I was going to be able to win the war with the fish, but I managed to get him up in the end after a very long struggle, and after that I was absolutely exhausted. But yeah, it was so fun. So I caught my tuna early on, my mackie early on, and then got smashed by the GT, and after that I had rubber arms. But you still keep fishing, you know, you just, yeah, everyone just still keeps kicking on and everyone else gets their fish. But the fish are good. You should have seen the size of the barra, how fat, how healthy they are, and how much they fight when you pull them in. So I'm hoping that I catch a good one today.
That's a black Jew.
Whoa. Oh my goodness.
We'll take our time here. You pretty much got him beat, mate.
Ooh.
Oh no way. Oh, that is huge.
Well done, mate. You did everything perfectly.
Oh my God. Woken up. Can't say I really just woke up because I've sort of been up all night. But geez, it's beautiful here. So there's just me, Murray, and Dad up here. We also have Rolf, who is the rocket scientist. Now, Rolf is a very impressive man, and you would like him very much. You boys would absolutely love him. Rolf is not only very clever, but he is also a gadget man. He's a good character, so it's going to be good fun. So Bluey, the camp owner, he's got two young fellas working with him. One of them's his son, Digby, and the other one is Tom. And both are really friendly, really knowledgeable, nice young guys. And yeah, it's been awesome.
It's really beautiful and colourful country, but really harsh and dangerous, and yeah, it's a wild adventure, but it is magnificent to look at. Just absolutely awesome.
Yeah.